Because he said that once, I tried that so many times. Don't do that tonight. And if you do have a point where you go, oh, this could make or break an audience, save it till the last of the 4 minutes that you have on Fox News. Because if you weren't watching, I was just filming a Fox News, whatever Tucker Carlson's replacement guy was. I just, for some reason, Fox News wants you to do 4 minutes. I have no affiliation. I am not known to you, half of you in this room, much less Fox News. And I go, all right.
Doug Stanhope's a comedian who joins us now. Doug.
I riffed it.
I don't know dog dick about Hunter Biden.
So I go, yeah, I'm probably going to get kicked off. You don't think I'm fucking mic'd up on my own? Go, okay, that's it. Have another one, Mr. Stanhope. I'm not even drunk. I'm on my third drink. I got a host tonight. I'm saying always say yes. See where it goes.
Good.
Awesome, man. Well, it's good to connect. We're looking forward to getting you on the show. I did want to reach out, though, to see if tomorrow might work instead. It doesn't look like we're going to have that story in tonight, so I want to see if tomorrow would maybe work for you.
It probably might work better for... I'll be up in Tucson, so that way they wouldn't have...
Oh, that actually would definitely make it easier, probably.
All right. We'll try to do it tomorrow.
Okay, awesome, man. Well, cool. We're looking at trying to probably do that story. Are you cool with also maybe doing some news of the day if there's something that comes up that we're like...
Yeah, the quicker you can kick me things that I should take a look at.
Yeah, for sure. It's usually around like this time. Can I give you a call like tomorrow around this time and I'll have like, you know, even if we're doing the traffic light story or the tickets, if there's maybe something else that comes up that's kind of funny, and then we can look into all... figure out if it makes sense to try to get you to the studio, send someone to you, whatever it's easier for you.
Yeah, either way.
Cool. Awesome, Doug. Well, sounds good. I'll give you a call around this time tomorrow, and we'll lock it in.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Excellent, man. Looking forward to it. Thanks so much.
All right, bye.
Well, that worked out.
Yeah. So it looks like they started... I don't know if this was originally a screw hole here or not.
That's some jet fires going right over our head.
And then it looks like you might be a little closer to like 8:40. Is that okay? I know you said you had something right after.
Yeah, but that's why I'm at that hotel. I just have to host an open mic for the kids. But it starts, it's at the same hotel.
Sorry, Michael, but I disagree. It is not cool to spend $1 million on drug-fueled sex parties and then try to get the IRS to pay for it. You know what? Actually, that's what I'm saying, and it does sound pretty cool.
Well, cool, man. Well, thanks so much, Doug. We're looking forward to having you join us. If anything, you need anything or any questions in the meantime, feel free to reach out. But the crew will be hitting you up once they're close by.
All right, great. Thanks.
Cool.
I'll come up. I don't know if we're going to be filming in the room or if the restaurant will allow us. But I'll on my way up from my room.
Okay, this world.
You're early, Chris Peterson. This one. So.
How are you, sir? Good. So I thought we'd be able to
film in the diner. I didn't know they opened at 5 o'clock. So technically, it's. I love it. I love the bar.
Here, you can sit right there and you can see the diner.
Great.
Okay. That's what I'll do. I'll start setting up.
So Mr. Sandhill brought that today, you guys, as something that he might like.
You have 30 minutes to figure out.
He would like some help on that bit.
Three bullet
I got one. Points.
Go ahead.
Okay.
This is my, I wrote this morning. It's different when I'm up on stage.
Okay.
Because, you know, the persona and
okay, well then let's put it in all conversation. Right. Hi, I'm a douchebag from Fox News, and with us we have the great comic I've never heard of until they said it into my earpiece,
right.
Doug Stanhope. It's an honor to have you here.
All right.
Hunter Biden, we showed the clip from Comedy Central. What do you make of this whole party guy, animal guy thing?
What I got is America's first son, Hunter Biden, got convicted of federal gun charges and tax evasion. He's gonna get pardoned by his dad, but I can't wait for his masterclass series. I can't wait for the modules on smoking crack, hiring hookers, and how to bang your brother's widow.
I don't know any details about this guy.
So
I
had to look it up. All true way. Things that he did. He banged his brother's wife. Like he's a wild child.
Right.
Yeah. You're cool.
This is what we need. This is why it's a writer's room. I banged my brother's wife.
Mm-hmm.
I've had hookers.
Yes.
I have not really smoked crack. God damn it. I fucking hate Chive TVs with all my fucking. Everywhere it is, it takes all the conversation, it takes your attention. It's fucking.
Oh, yeah.
The fucking devil.
I can't believe it's
like, I said to your bartender out there, I've never said this in my life, but could you please turn that to Fox TV? Fox News. Yeah. Hey, we're about to, we're going after this segment, so I'll give you the high side one. When you turn into extras.
Yeah.
The Hunter Biden story has it all. You have drugs, prostitutes, sex tapes, guns, dirty wires, tax dodges, and so much more. Diamonds. How could I forget the diamonds? It's the kind of bad boy story that Hollywood would have picked up in a heartbeat, but not in Washington. Democrats spent years doing everything but talking about Hunter. But if you think about it, if you're a Democrat, why would you want to talk about him? We just thought Democrats were embarrassed, but we were wrong. Turns out Democrats fell for the bad boy. And like a high school girl hiding it from her parents, they've been hiding their urges until now. When the media found out Hunter shafted the IRS and blew $1 million on sex, Democrats were orgasmic.
Yes, these charges against Hunter paint the picture of a deeply troubled man. But on the other hand, these charges also paint a picture of a man who is, and I can't stress this enough, so cool.
Cool? What is cool about this?
Oh, great question. Everything? I mean, the 2-week benders, the sex clubs. He's like a one-man episode of Entourage, the coolest show. The guy even got kicked out of hotels for partying too hard.
I'm sorry, Michael, but I disagree. It is not cool to spend $1 million on drug-fueled sex parties and then try to get the IRS to pay for it. You know what? Actually... So I'm saying it does sound pretty cool.
I mean, they're saying Hunter's partying like a rock star. He's taking millions out from ATMs. He's deducting strippers as business expenses. He's going 170 in the panorama with the crack pipe. And he just gave the bird to the IRS. Is that cool? Am I old-fashioned? I always thought sleeping with your brother's widow and skipping alimony payments to your ex was bad, or getting all your friends arrested and dishonoring your family name and dishonoring your father. Or not acknowledging the baby you had with another woman. But what do I know? Maybe Hunter's alpha. Not only is Hunter the smartest guy Joe knows, he's the coolest. And after 3 years of Joe, Democrats want cool back in the White House.
Hunter's got Lambos, porn, sweet clothes. What's Trump got? A golf cart, high cholesterol, and indictments? Indictments about documents? Boring. Good luck in the election, nerd. People always say they like Biden, but they wish he were younger. Well, you got your wish, Democrats. Hunter Biden 2024. You don't even have to change the signs.
That sounds so cool.
Sorry, Newsom. Hunter's on deck. Doug Stanhope's a comedian who joins us now. Doug, I mean, I miss this. Hunter's cool.
You know, first of all, I have no party affiliation. I am wingless. I am a grubworm maggot. I don't care either. But you're completely ignoring that they were making fun of themselves as much as anyone. I listened to the sketch. I don't know dog dick about Hunter Biden. I have a home life and I do things. I don't. But Hunter Biden isn't a new story. Like, if you go back to Betty Ford had problems. Were you trashing her for being an alcoholic? The guy's evidently a drug addict. He's having some fun, I guess. Billy Bush, Billy Carter, Billy Beer. Wasn't that funny in the moment? Did we have to wait a long time? Chelsea Clinton, you know, she sold a bunch of top secrets to WikiLeaks and changed her gender. All of the presidential families have had issues. Why Hunter Biden is specifically chafing your crack?
Well, I think because Hunter has had all of the issues that everyone has ever had in the history of first families. And I'm fine with it because this whole time I didn't realize how cool
he was. I banged my brother's wife while he was getting... The night before my brother graduated boot camp at Paris Island, I banged his fiance in a pool in a Holiday Inn at 17. Okay. So I was technically a rape victim, too.
All right.
I'm saying we've all done things.
We've all done things. You've done quite a few things this evening. Have another one, Stanhope. Love you.
I just started.
I can tell.
Yeah. I didn't get to the stuff that was going to get me chucked off. Of course they dumped me. You don't think I'm fucking mic'd up on my own because I have my own camera crew on your camera crew. Of course I'm getting dumped.
Yeah. I guess we're done. All right. So you were trying to get dumped.
No, I knew I was going to get dumped eventually, but I'm not that early.
That was quick. That was quick.
I wasn't planning on my brother's life story.
Cheers. So they just cut it?
Yeah.
Yeah, have another one.
What?
I should have flashed on them.
Yeah, you should have.
Yeah.
You should have flashed on them. Well, we're back on here.
I wasn't going to look up fucking Hunter Biden and try to become some big expert. There's things that I don't care about, and it's the world and things that go around in it. So Hunter Biden is one of those things you go, okay, you can't study this quickly anymore. There's things on either side of the aisle, the parties, the wings, where, okay, it starts at the headline, and then it goes through speculation and et cetera, and it always ends up with fucking kids on Epstein Island. And you don't know where the news, like, okay, which channel were you watching? Because I just riffed it.